Hello, and welcome to another episode of Isn't That Something? I'm Ralph Crew, and today will be my second video. I mean, this video is about seconds, and it's my first video about seconds that I've ever made. It's also the third video on this channel. Unless you count the intro, then it's the fourth video. I guess you could say this is my first, second, third, or fourth video. When we use the word second or seconds, we could mean silver medals or going back for more mashed potatoes and gravy or your assistant in an old-timey duel. None of these things are what I want to talk about today. I instead want to talk about the unit of measurement, the second. The second, as a measurement of the passage of time, is defined by the International System of Units, or SI, to be the amount of time it takes the outermost electron of an unperturbed, ground state, cesium-133 atom to vibrate between two hyperfine states 9,192,631,770 times. Next time you see a cesium-133 atom chilling in its ground state, try counting the hyperfine transitions of its valence electron for a fun activity that you can try at home. While it might seem like this definition of a second is as old as time, it was only put into place in 1967 with the invention and widespread adoption of atomic clocks, which use cesium atoms to keep time with an accuracy good enough to lose a second only once every 100 million years.
Wow.
Just 100 million years is about 15 quadrillion seconds, so that seems like a pretty good clock. Before the atomic clock era, the second was based on a fraction of a tropical year. The tropical year is defined by the interval of time it takes the sun to precisely restart the cycle of the seasons. Think more about the interval of time between two vernal equinoxes and less about Jimmy Buffett. That is a tropical year. The year was chosen to define the second because quartz oscillator clocks were doing a better job of keeping time than the rotation of the Earth. A quartz oscillator clock keeps time by jiggling back and forth like a fancy tuning fork. Since quartz is a fancy kind of mineral called a piezoelectric crystal, it puts out a little nugget of electricity for every jiggle. These jiggle nuggets are then amplified and used to keep the tuning fork jiggling in a self-reinforcing feedback loop. A much more in-depth and sensible and honestly entertaining explanation can be found in Steve Mould's brilliant video. Before quartz oscillators were a thing, folks used to define a second as just a fraction of a day. You probably have heard of the typical divisions of the day. If you divide a day into 24 equal length chunks of time, then you've got hours. If you then divide an hour into 60 equal bits, you've got minutes. If you divide the hour into 60 a second time, you get seconds. This is where seconds come from. They're the second division of the hour.
Wow.
This also means that you could call minutes firsts, although if you do, you are in a minute minority of the timekeeping community. A second is a relatively short amount of time. If you try hard, you can probably say the word second 5 or 6 times in a second. Try it with me. Second, 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 second,
second, second, second, second,
second, second,
second, second,
second, second, second,
second, second,
second, second,
second, second, second,
second, second, second, second, second,
second, second, second,
second, second, second, second,
second, second, second, second,
second, second, second, second,
second, second, second, second,
second, second, second,
second, second,
second, second, second,
second, second, second, second,
second, second, second,
second, second,
second, second, second,
second, second, second,
second, second, second,
second, second, second,
second, second, second,
second,
second, second, second, second, second, second.
If you manage to say second with a frequency of 6 spoken seconds per second, then you are producing a second pulse of 6 hertz, a unit of frequency relating the number of cycles per second. Other notable things that can take place in 1 second include the following. You create 2 million red blood cells in a second. There are 8 hours of video uploaded to YouTube in a second. There are about 4 babies born on Earth every second. 4 million tons of the sun's mass is converted directly into energy in a second. 2.4 people have been Rickrolled every second for the last 10 years. Clearly, a lot can happen in a second. Using the term seconds to describe the second division of a larger measurement is not limited to timekeeping, however. Angles are also cut up into seconds and to an even higher degree than hours. When measuring angles in degrees, it is customary to divide a single degree into 60 subunits, also called minutes. This is most often done by astronomers measuring the angular distance between stars or the angular size of an astronomical object. Angular minutes are often referred to as arc minutes. A relatable example would be how to describe the size of the moon in the sky. From the surface of the Earth, the moon is just larger than half a degree in angular size, typically about 31 arc minutes. This is similar to the width of your thumbnail held at arm's length. On a side note, The little whitish crescent moon bit of your nail is called a lunula and is roughly the same angular size as the moon when viewed at arm's length.
Wow.
What if we want to measure astronomical objects with a much smaller angular size? Well, then we'd want to take a second division of the degree, also known as an arcsecond. A relatable example would be the planet Jupiter, which, when observed at its closest point to Earth, appears as a disk with a diameter of about 50 arcseconds. A much harder to relate to example would be the supermassive black hole at the center of the galaxy known as M87, whose angular size is about 50 millionths of an arcsecond. This image might seem a bit low res, but it is quite possibly the finest precision image in history, with an angular size approaching that of a jelly donut, seen at the distance of the moon. Do not attempt to eat the supermassive black hole at the heart of M87, it will eat you. Despite having such a tiny angular size, this is an enormously large object. The black hole's mass is estimated to be about 6.5 billion times greater than that of the Sun, with a diameter of about 120 times the size of the orbit of the Earth. It only looks small because it's far away. So far, in fact, that light takes 54 million years, or 1.7 quadrillion seconds, to get from there to here. Knowing this, we can describe the distance to M87 as being 54 million light years, or 1.7 quadrillion light seconds. Astronomers don't actually use light years or light seconds very much, but they instead use another second-flavored measurement, the parsec. A parsec is short for a parallax second. Parallax is a method of measuring the distance to an object based on a shift in the position of the observer. Try closing one eye and holding your thumb out at arm's length, covering up a spot on some distant object. Now, switch eyes. See how your thumb seems to move? Magic. If you did fancy trigonometry, you could measure the angle difference in where your thumb appears, and if you knew exactly how far apart your eyes were, you could reason out how far away your thumb was. Astronomers have been able to do this with distant stars, although they don't use their thumbs or eyes. Well, they do use their eyes, but mostly to interpret data from telescopes taken 6 months apart. This takes advantage of the fact that the Earth moves a fair distance around the Sun throughout the year. If we know the distance to the Sun, or the astronomical unit, then we can reason out the absolute distance to our target star. The distance at which the angle created by an astronomical unit is equal to one arcsecond is thus known as a parallax second, or parsec, roughly 3.3 light years, or 19 trillion miles, just over 30 trillion kilometers. It's also important to note that despite what you've heard from hockey legend Phil Kessel, or from any thousand-year-old falcon-related sources, a parsec is a measurement of distance, not a measurement of time, unlike our old friend, the regular second. The time version of a second is not only useful in and of itself as the SI base unit for time, but is also handy in deriving other units of measurement, such as velocity and acceleration. In most physics applications, velocity is expressed in meters per second. We already mentioned the light second as a unit of measurement. A light second is roughly 186,000 miles, or 300,000 kilometers. Another second-based distance measurement is the beard second, which is the distance an average human beard grows in 1 second, roughly 10 nanometers. Now, I could go on and on about seconds, but by now it's been
many
seconds, and that seems long enough for my first, second, third, or fourth video. Next time you think about units that you use to measure time, give a second thought to seconds and think to yourself, isn't that something? Isn't That Something is written, recorded, and edited by me, Ralph Crew. Music is provided by Kyle Simpson. Second time thumb model provided by movie star Kelsey Robinson. Special thanks to Steve Mold for inspiring me with his quartz watch video. Huge thanks to everybody who shared a video of themselves saying, second, 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 second. After the end of the video, well, before the end of the video, but after the credits, a longer version of the winner of the second, second, second competition will be shown. Now, I have to be clear, I didn't frame it as a competition when I told people about it, but after seeing his video, Hakeem Bilal is clearly the winner, the first place among seconds. Of course, if you like these videos, please like, subscribe, hit the bell, and also share the channel with other nerds that you also think might like it. I'm having a lot of fun making these and would like to make a lot more. Thanks for watching, and explore the world responsibly.
second.